I talk with people that are having me vet a WordPress candidate before getting to finalists, these are some of the questions that we tend to like to ask, because it tells us, does this person fit our needs? How many sites have you launched? Right? Because launching is different from fixing. By sites, it could be microsites, things like that. How many of them are similar to what we're doing? Please let us take a look at them. Are they still live? If they're not live, there may be a reason why. But if all of them are not live, find out, because there should be a good repertoire. And of course, can you talk with the clients? Sometimes you may not be able to for very specific reasons. And then we bridge to things like, do you do the customization of themes and plugins? And I like to ask that because it gets into some areas that a client of mine discovered years ago, and it's always the lesson always stuck with me when they decided to have some special programming built. They didn't ask about support afterward, and so I asked. I always have clients work with me to plan out what will support be like, and then it's always good to know who's really working on it, because if it's being worked with on associate level or people that are in the place right there sitting in front of common screens, that's a different matter. One is not better than the other. I can tell you that. But I'd rather know through transparency, here's how we're set up. Because it just really helps set expectations and clarity on a good relationship. And a statement of who works on what is always good. Most importantly is that last one. My client did not ask who owned the code on a particular piece of their e-commerce website. And it rested, the ownership of the proprietary, of that information was proprietary. It was a non-WordPress site, but they built it specifically for them. And there became issues afterward because they parted company without trying to pay the programmer, and that was just not a good thing. And fortunately, he got paid, and their site's still running. But they didn't ask, and they assumed incorrectly. It's always good to find out what the expectation is, because some designers and some developers will work with only raw code, with placeholder. I've known some people to receive a site without ever being asked for content by a developer, and sophisticated sites, not just little sites, and the developer said, okay, here we go, you've been seeing comps and everything, we're set, and they wonder, well, who's going to put all the content in? And it was being assumed that their staffers were going to be doing that. So knowing when everything is needed is very important with any scaled site launch. And then what are the process steps that we're going to have? It's always good to know, when you need to receive things, when we'll get things back, and how do you need it received, et cetera. These may seem like basic elements, but depending on the designer, the developers and designers that you're working with, they may not have necessarily followed the same plan in the past. So it's always worth checking. It always brings me comfort when I see a development resource come back and say, here's our plan, here's how we work, and it meets my expectations.